So you said about a very nice part that when you talk about the Occam Razor. Occam Razor appears as a curiosity on the series called Dr. House. Initially, they're trying to save a patient. Then they try to use the Occam Razor principle. Okay, maybe you said something. It's not just you. I heard as a Professor Hans. He used to say that as well when he's talking to Como Lake about the complexity. I remember that he put a sentence on his slides that he believes sometimes to the opposite. Instead of just go for simplicity, as Einstein used to say that you have to go to the simplicity. But he seems that biology is not so nice. Biology sometimes goes to the complexity because sometimes the same gene can do several functions. So simplicity is not always the way of biology. There is a model called the OCIC information criteria, AIC, and maybe you know this kind of technique, that you try to select the simplest model. So maybe we can talk a little bit more about complexity and simplicity in biology. Can you really make simple models, or you have to maybe accept that biology is not so simple as physics is? Maybe you have to move to go to complex model, you don't have a choice.
Mm-hmm. Yes, actually, we can make both models, and they can be useful in simple models and more complicated. In simple, we mean that we include less entities in the model. For example, less number of molecules, less interactions. And we don't say that simple models are not useful and we should always choose complicated model with more interactions. But we say that if we have two models equally well describing some behavior with fewer number, let's say, of interactions and with higher number, then we can... Then according to Occam, you should choose the simpler model and say that it's also the most correct one. More likely it's to be correct because we don't include some extra, let's say, molecules in this model. But what we would like to propose that the more correct should be the more detailed model because we know that these components exist. So if we remove them, maybe for this behavior it's still not so important, but model will be less correct. It could be... The usefulness of both models could be the same, for example. We just talk about what is the most correct, and we cannot extrapolate this principle that a simpler model is the more correct one, the more likely to be the correct. This is how Occam formulated it. We think right. That more complicated model, more detailed model, let's say, more detailed model would be more likely to be the correct one.
Okay, Professor Hearn, he did a kind of comment. Can you see his comment?
Yes, sure. Yeah, important for the argument is that we know the complexity and then it is limited since we have the genome sequences. Yes, exactly. Because in Occam, he was fighting against the anti-cosmology. So there were two models of universe. One is Newton mechanics and another model based on more complicated interactions between different gods. But in biology, we know this, that there is a genome, we know how many genes are there. So in principle, we could expect that the more correct model would be, which include all these genes and all these molecules, which are really present in life.
So maybe you can say that it was a kind of misunderstanding of his principle, that his principle is somehow correct, but was interpreted in a out of context way, like he... I'll give one example of what I'm doing now. Right now I'm studying a technique called the test-driven design. It's a different way of making computer problems. So instead of you do the computer problem, you first test your program, then go backward doing your code. So maybe this principle of the simplicity is more like this. It's a principle that you should go for the simplicity, but you should not. You not always get the simplest model, but you get the simplest model amongst the models that are correct. Maybe it could be more or less like this.
Hans, I would agree. Yeah, there is no basis for Occam's principles, really.
Yes.
In this context, in this time, it was useful for his particular situation, but it cannot be now extrapolated, taken like a complete principles for all science. let's say.
Yes, maybe with the case of Einstein used to go for simplicity, but there is no proof that Einstein was correct. He said that the simplest model was the correct one, but it was a principle. There is no way that Professor Hans was the first one I saw in Como Lake. He wrote like a sentence. I remember that he talked about that in his talk. And I like the way he's talking because sometimes you assume that something is true, but not stop to think about that maybe it's just a kind of old way of thinking. In the past, they didn't have computer. Nowadays, you can solve an equation in a manifest way. So you don't have any more to go for the simplicity. Now you can build very complex models. Of course, you have to be careful because sometimes you can be overfitting. You can like to fit an elephant. It's not necessary to do that, but sometimes, but if you can go to simplicity, but you have to go complexity, sometimes you have to make a equilibrium, a kind of a balance between complexity and simplicity.
Actually, I would not agree, because this is not about what we should do. Of course, we should balance for our practical usage, but when we compare to models, then still if we have all molecules, if you have 22,000 genes in our model, this model would be more likely to be the correct comparing with model from 5 genes. Still it's. And we should not look for some balance in terms that, okay, 22,000 is too much and 5 is too little. Let's take, let's say, 10,000. It's not this balance. It's just we can use this model. Maybe it would be the most useful model. This not complete and not simplified, but still, I believe that the more detailed it would be, more likely to be the correct one. So still this 22,000 genes model would be more likely to be the correct than model with 10,000 genes.
Yes. So yes, that's it. When you go through biology, you have maybe to rethink that maybe the idea of physics is not completely correct to biology. So in this case, you have to go to complexity. There is no choice. I mean, you said something very nice on your talk.
Did you like the content of this channel? So please subscribe to the channel. It's quite simple. You just have to hit subscribe and you can decide which level of the notification you want. You may choose all the notification, which means that everything that I do, you receive a notification on your bell here on the upper corner, or you can choose no notification. I would strongly recommend you to subscribe, even if you don't want to receive all the notifications. Just hit here, no notification, or hit the one that you like the most. It's pretty important that you subscribe to the channel so I can achieve a high number of subscribers, and people can as well understand that this channel has a nice content to offer, and YouTube will understand as well that it can make a nice divulgation of the channel. So please subscribe to the channel.